Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside.
The Pirates rebounded home against William. Huge crowd, setting season attendance records and establishing the basis for multi-postseason honors for players and team with back-to-back unbeaten seasons in Ficklin Stadium. Miner got 19 on the first play for the Pirates. Then Ingram off the rip another 19 yards. Jimmy Walden gets the call for the first score from 4 yards out. Quickly, East Carolina leads 7-0. Back-to-back pass interceptions first stop the Indians on their first two possessions. The second interception here is picked off by linebacker Mike Grant. After the Ingram to Biner, setting up another score from 15 yards. The score by Jimmy Walden. The Pirates lead 13-0, and rolling over William & Mary. A fake field goal by William & Mary is foiled by an alert ECU defense, with Clint Harris making the key hit. Minute picks up 16 yards off the left side. Ernest Biner rips up another of his fine, hard-nosed runs for 28 more yards. Tony Baker gets the call on the option, 18 yards, and the Pirates have an early, easy 21-0 lead. On the next series, the powerful Pirate offense rolls to a 27-0 lead. Subite at halftime. Along with offense, great defense, like Mike Grant, adding some defensive spice on this hit. The final result, East Carolina 40 to... Only one game remains, the Mud Bowl. Amid rain, wind, lightning, and tornado warnings, the Pirate defense had to play tough early, as poor field position gave Southern Mississippi two quick touchdown opportunities. But East Carolina's defense will hold on both series of plays after turning over the football. After showing great improvement from the beginning of the season till now, it appears that the Pirate defense has gelled. Despite the windy conditions, this 46-yard field goal is good, and the Golden Eagles lead 3-0. But again, the Pirate defense stands stiff, making play after play to hold Southern the end zone early. Great defense allows Southern Miss but a 4-yard field goal. And Southern Miss now takes a 6-0 halftime lead. Conditions worsened during the second half, but Henry Williams opened the second period with a hard romp that almost resulted in a Pirate score. Then, Onfina fails to score the touchdown. A good defensive stand late in the third quarter will net the ball to East Carolina at the Southern Mississippi 22-yard line following this very poor Eagle punt. Quickly, the East Carolina offense moves in towards the score behind the strong efforts of All-South fullback Ernest Biner. Ingram looks to the end zone and tosses a scoring strike to who makes a fine catch near the back of the end zone. With the extra point boot by Jeff Heath, East Carolina leads 7-6. The rains are very heavy. playing conditions. Southern Mississippi can't handle the football, and Clint Harris comes up with a key fumble recovery. Jimmy Walden gets and sets up a final field goal for the Pirates. Under most adverse conditions, Jeff Heath makes good on a 37-yard field goal, and the Pirates have a 10-6 lead. Then it becomes time for the pound the belts and chin straps as Southern Mississippi blocks a punt and gets the ball at the Pirate 15 with 2:13 to play. But East Carolina's defense kept saying no to Eagle efforts. The finest hour for a Pirate defense has come a long way in 11 games. The net results on this messy night are mighty sweet. East Carolina wins the Mudducks in Hattiesburg, Mississippi.
Sponsored by Carl Johnson Dotson, where you can buy a new Nissan car or truck for... And by Kentucky Fried Chicken. They do chicken right. Here's Kenny Hoff and Dick Jones.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Pirate Football Pregame Show. And we are about a half a game away against the Florida State Seminoles. And you were watching there on the opening 15 scores last year, 47-46 the final score. And it certainly was a great game, and it could be again.
Well, Kenny, it's an exciting game from last year, but that's out of the books. Neither coach wants to talk about last year. Both new year. The Pirates, well, they're young, and they're looking. 8-3 last year, can they top it? Florida State, Coach Bowden went out and hired a USFL defensive coordinator to look for some strong defense. And I don't know why, Kenny, I want to throw this out, but in Bowden's record, you know, he's never suffered a tie. He has never suffered a tie ball game.
That could be an interesting thing to see later on in the game. We're going to be looking at the quarterbacks in this game. We're going to be looking at a couple of impact players, Henry Williams and Greg Allen of the Florida State Seminoles, have on this game this year. And we're going to take a look once again at last year's highlights, all that when we come back in a couple of minutes. Going into the preseason of 1980 Pirate Camp has been the quarterback situation. And earlier this week, I talked with Coach Ed Emery about the situation going into the Florida State game.
Our offensive quarterback situation is the question right now. We have a three quarterback situation and make our decisions based on what they do defensively, based on what the situation is at Florida State, based on the alignments and so forth, but also